Free your mind now. Be part of People's Pan-African Parliament, the Pan-African Pyramid Debate, with your speaker, Andrew Irumba Katusabe.
Yeah, my name is Andrew Irumba Katusabe, your speaker, and I'm glad that you joined me again, yet again, for another interesting topic. Tonight, we are discussing the untapped opportunities, the youth of Africa. So we want to learn from our elders. How can we utilize our useful years on this planet? And what are those untapped opportunities that you may not be seeing, but some other people who have gone through those experiences are seeing them? And ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Hasmukh Dauda is a distinguished regional businessman, entrepreneur, industrialist, and philanthropist in Uganda and Kenya. He is the proprietor of Britannia Ride Industries Uganda Limited, commonly known as Splash and House of Manji in Kenya. Dauda was born in the 1950s and he's about 72 years today, I think, 72, 73. He was born to a family of modest means. I didn't want to say poor, I just used the word modest means. They could not afford something salt, and so they went without salt, but they had that dinner. Actually, he was born with the other 10 other siblings in Indere village, Siaya County in Kenya. Now most of you, when you see me, you may say, this is Indian. That's what comes into your brain. This is a Kenyan, this is a Ugandan, this is an African. He was actually born here in Kenya. Mr. Dauda attended Indere Primary School in Kenya, not in India, but dropped out of school at the age of 13 because of an inability to pay school fees. He went into business for himself, beginning with hawking confectionery. An Indian shopkeeper offered him a job at Kenya shillings, 150 per month. He was able to save that money anyway and raised about Kenya shillings 2,000 by the age of 19. And he put that money as a down payment on a Kenya shillings 5,000 pickup truck, paying the balance in installments. He actually opened a retail shop in his home village in Indere, Nairobi, Kenya. In 1970, he began processing molasses at rented premises. Using equipment that he already owned, he began buying raw material directly from the farmers, with whom he had good relations. He also began trading in cotton and fresh fruit. 5 years later, he built a Uhoro factory, a jaggery or molasses factory that runs up to date. In 1985, he established Jambo Biscuits Limited, a confectionery maker under the House of Dauda Group of companies in Kenya. In the mid-90s, he moved to Uganda and started Britannia Ride Industries Limited, a company that processes fresh fruits to make Splash. He has since established other companies in both Kenya and Uganda. And in 2002, Mr. Dauda used some of his assets in Uganda to buy House of Manji in Kenya, a confectionery maker, which was collapsing. He pumped a lot of money in that company and experienced human capital and revived the business up to date. In fact, after the war, around 1989, Yoweri Museveni was moving in solid areas around and saw a lot of abandoned fallen mangoes from the mango trees. Others were being wasted by buyers. He then called Dauda, who was in Nairobi at that time. They would later meet at Sorot General. Museveni then narrated to him, Mr. Dauda, that he had seen a lot of mangoes being wasted in Teso sub-region and that he was looking for an investor who could add value to the same by processing them into trees. And so Dauda went and started thinking how he could make that dream come. And a few years later, Splash Mango was born. Don't you think it deserves a round of applause there?
When I was in Uganda and when I got an opportunity to, 20 years back, to buy a very huge biscuit factory called Manji Biscuit when it was a receiver, and it was my dream when I was a child. Manji Biscuit in the 50s was a very favorite biscuit, only biscuits. So even my mother will tell, when she went to UK, said, I want Manji Biscuit. So I had a dream. Because when I was a shopkeeper, I was buying Manji Biscuit in there in Siaya village. So when I got this opportunity, I told my son, you know, that let me try and bid it and we get it. and it was completely run down for 2 years. But because of there was an election, first time changing hands from Moi, president like Moi, so people are fearing. That always we have fear in Africa. When election is near, people are in question. Riots, problems, looting. So people do not keep you on stocks or buy any assets. So this was the, I took that challenge. When my family says, no, it's not the right time, I said, no. I always like to take this opportunity. There's nothing going to happen in this country. So why I'm telling you, but first thing, before I left, I remember with today an RDC, but I was always telling him like my son, you, we started some farming near Bali, and agriculture, maize planting, cassava, and I told him, you must continue. And mango, when he told me, when he came to me in Mombasa, he had apple mango. So he told me, he said, I want seedlings of apple mango, because the mango was a dream. It was not, but it was when suddenly came when I was important. And when His Excellency, President Museveni told me that his cotton is very laborious job. I came to open it, didn't, but I can't criticize, but help. But I saw after cotton what? So I traveled in northern, eastern Uganda, everywhere until Arua, Jumani, you name in the country. So I found a lot of fruits, he's right. So when I put this proposal to my family, he says, oh, you are mad. When my son says, Papa, what do you think? If free pineapple people can eat, Ugandans can. My researchers, marketing says, no. Investing $4-5 million and they will and taking the loan, and again, who will drink? Tetra Pak. I say, I don't want to hear that. We will do it. Because mango was, he said, just go with the truck, take it free or whatever. I say, no. There must be solution for that. And that is where I started challenging. After opposition in my group, I said, no, we must do it. And this is where I took some of the people from here, and for agronomists, and to see how mango can be. We have many trees, but it was not properly pruned or productive. So I went to India, one of the big function of today is the Prime Minister of India, Narendra Modi. But 15 years back, he was just a governor, was chief minister in Gujarat. So I said, I want an opportunity when I met to see the farms. And that time I had with me
Professor Jubal Mukherjee.
Yeah, so and he had eye operation in that hospital, and I knew it all. So he said, let's not go in big place, let's go into the farm. And I have all the videos and photos to see what is farming and how much best yield we are getting. So when I brought some Indians from the rural area, not very educated, but who has a good farm, to come and train with people here, I think you know. So what is happening, that I knew that there is a lot of opportunity in processing the fruits. It was very difficult for 2 years when I was not breaking it, but then we became number one, compete with the Del Monte in Kenya, and in juice, and exporting our juices to Kenya, even to neighbor countries, and the quality. So we had to blend a little bit in the beginning to bring the aroma from India, little bit. Then I made a system that all the farmers, they were being cheated by middle people. So I went through to say, how can we bring farmers direct and motivate them? I don't want to go much in that, because there are a lot of things that I do not know I can now, because they have covered, but I will request our young generation. See, always politicians or everybody, we are just talking and talking and preaching. Like a friend was telling about God, and I support him, that every time we have become beggars, oh God, help me. God says, you take one step first. I have given you energy, power, and wisdom. You have got a part here. Why all the time you are begging and shouting? I tell many people that He has given us a life, and we have to select, do. So I was very happy when he was, because I know. Also, I tell people, don't be blind, because you are being trapped. But unfortunately, we have to walk the talk. I was a peace ambassador, even for youth in Chad, even in Kenya. After 12 years, I resigned because I found billions of money was coming in the name of youth and NGOs, making them lazy. And no money was going even 10% to the youth. When there was a project of Kibera, surveying of the toilet box, how many toilets we need. When I asked one of our colleagues in embassy, UN. It was in UN. He says we have only a budget of $1.5 million for research, but we have spent $900,000, but there is still not coming. We are waiting. I said, I have in my fingertip, we have 42 villages in the Kibera, and how much toilet we need. We have a youth ready, and we don't want to panic. Add some money, little bit there, $2 million. And from $1.5 to $2 million, you will find the toilet ready. So I need one for myself. The budget of toilet for men and women, it was 5.5 million or nearly 6 million. I did it with 2 million and better toilet. And I brought them. I said, this is it. So why I'm telling you, NGOs, and one time I was very annoyed. I said, NGO, nothing going on. They take money, and our people want free money. So they take photograph everywhere and send it, and they get funding. So, and again now, latestly I started, when I decided to retire from the business and do the social work, more for empowerment. And I had a form, I was telling, now I can say, well, RDC, but it's like my, today I told him, we have a form, when you come to Mombasa, I told him that we gave the form to the youth, what can you do? What is your vision? I have 7 questions, Philip. I don't want vocational training and they have nothing to do. So I started group. I told them making best shoes. There were some people who were making and selling, some Indians or Europeans were buying from them with 800 or 1,000 shillings of Kenya. And they were selling with $70-$80 in online in London and in Italy. So I met them, I said, no, stop this business. Let me bring you material, stitching more, and I give you a place. Let us do regularly online, you know? And we registered them. And the women and everyone, we are selling. There would not make even 10,000 per month. Here the group coming together can make more than a million. And I did. And this shoes was highly in the market. I convinced the supermarket to keep them. And what I'm telling you, I said, you people are making 100. Here we'll make double. It is selling 2,000. So what I'm telling you, youth here, education. And these are not in Kibera all educated. But only the problem of youth, problem of young men today. Eat, drink, enjoy, mobile, dance, all night, be drunk, and every bad thing, drug. And in Kibera, betting, millions of highest money and revenue of going to betting in Kenya was from slum. Kibera, 100 shilling, 200. I said, why don't you make consortium and make that money and start business? Finally, I don't want to go in more detail. When there was the election riots, also I talked to more than 5,000 youth. Please, you are going to kill yourself and throw in stone. What are you going to get? So somehow I got very good success in agriculture also. Now, lastly, there was a very dangerous area called Morocco and river cleaning. In the name of river cleaning, millions of dollars comes, but nothing happens. So I told them, let us start 100 meter cleaning. I will send you some clips. And I said, you will claim some land also. So I was supporting local farmers by Bushnek. Cleaning and now very nice modern agriculture. I trained them since about 6 months in one of my small farm and make sure every hut, there were at least 3 bags of sukuma, wiki or manan, and I trained these women, young people. And really young people, and today I have women, one time I will send you, and you can show them any week when you are sent, and today I'm proud. We started with 12 women and about 8-10 boys. Now they are more than getting employed. They have self-employment. And now recently they sent me a figure, it's about 268. But never would everybody's land. We were cleaning, pollution cleaning, and now UN and a lot of European people are coming and sponsoring also. So I'm telling you, all speeches I have heard, but here about agriculture, I'm very interested much, because that is even my vision to see that agriculture today in the world, food security is most needed. And when you are talking about pizza, pasta, Western food, it's not our food, come on. It's a stupid thing. Eating it, you go many restaurants full of this outside food. We have a natural nutrition food in our country. When I tell my grandchildren, you are eating this rubbish, junk. I call that a junk food. Pasta, pizza, packed food from abroad is called junk food, full of chemical, affecting your health. And we are all, I would say, but I don't mind, I tell you, my grandson, you all young people are stupid. Sending, we went spend 5,000 in a restaurant, with 500 you can eat a lot of good food. So please respect your health first. You are eating a poison. I was selling the street in the bus in 1963. I didn't have money, no school fees. And I learned from my young African brothers in my age, 12, 13. So I said, how do you do? And getting one bag of sweet was 3 shillings 80 cents I didn't have. So I told my mother, he says, but you can't afford even, I can't give you. So he gave me some broken utensils, I sold, I got 1 shilling 20 cents. I went to shopkeeper, I said, please trust me. 1 3 shillings and 80 cents, Madhwani satin gold sweet. And I tried, and I sold it evening, I got 4 shillings and 20 cents. I went to the shopkeeper, I said, all this day, including 1 shilling 20, it was 40 profit. But give me one small bag for white paper, man, 2 shillings. And he gave me full credit of 5 shillings. Just to tell you, I don't want to say who I am, but I really suffered. Then I got a job of ten boy, of loaders, then unloading and going into the with the driver as a ten boy, but I learned how to do the sales. Finally, I decided to buy my pickup, because my salary was very low. So second-hand pickup, and from local men, he tried to repair it for me in 69, but since 63, I was struggling. Only I made money on 12th December 1963, when there was the independence of Kenya. All London, everybody left the village, but people came, so I started selling the flag, independent. And I was working in petrol pumps, so I put the window on the windscreen with small green glue thing in the local, you know, made. So I get 50 cents, otherwise it was a 10 cents. So I made money and badges. So every politicians come, we put this flag in his car, one in the street, you know. So I made 512 shillings in 4 days. So then I made this small kiosk. You've seen the photo.
Yeah.
Small kiosk, and my stock was 500. I was proud. And how did I make these boxes wooden when people were selling home and the horse were coming in the wooden thing? So when they are throwing, I collect. I know when I will build a box. And that is how I started. And my really business journey started in 69 when I said, I'm not getting timely salary. I talk 7 days, evening I come and I'm tired from the work, and again you have to do the small packing, no holiday. 6:30 you are at the work in the village called Nere in CI district. So you know, we have gone through that big journey. Nothing is impossible, but you people have become, today's young people, I said, they are lazy. They only know full night dancing and sweating and having these drugs and alcohol. And even the girls of today, they want to say, if I get a boy, you can buy mobile for me. Okay, now it's finished. I get another boyfriend, and you people also, another girl. What is this nonsense? Come on. You are wasting the hard-working money of your parents who has maybe sold their farm or cows to educate you, and you want a degree. And like you were telling, I've seen working in UK in toilets, in airport, washing, and in Dubai. This is a stupid nature, attitude. Come on, be positive, change. You can add a lot of value to herbs and spices. This COVID brought us a one side of blessings to the herbal medicines. And in Uganda, we can grow a lot of spices and herbs and export it. People are health conscious. We have best ginger we can grow here, which we all need. Best garlic, and you process it, pack it, you will get 100 times, not 10 times of value when you do the packing. Even aloe vera, even this neem, we call it marbaini. These are all, moringa is the best for bones and calcium. Pack it.
Moringa.
Yes. Too much. You go in Malindi, north, they are packing and people are buying, they are exporting. I brought a lot of samples for some people here that why. In a small town in Malindi, and a young man, after learning his father was doing some cotton business, but he says, I want to start in Malindi, there are a lot of need. And so today, believe me, everything is possible. Education should add value to you, but not a degree paper. It's a toilet paper, so it doesn't clean anything. I don't say don't be educated, but use it. For, you make a task force committee. I think I told you in RDC, you have corporate B10 and 2020 groups. What can we do? We are friends, don't compete with each other in jealousy. Say, yes, I have some talent. Make a consortium of 5 together, 10 together. Give a proposal. Only problem of you are our many people. Yeah, accountability is not there. If you bet, you must have a good accountability. See, the only, as I told you, you need to take more responsibility and be serious. Change your attitude. Problem, problem all the time. Every problem is a solution. Government is not doing that. My parents have not done this. Then my neighbor is having a rich. He has a computer. I don't have complaining. Everything. Why don't you bring a positive attitude and solution for it? So please, young people, have patience. Dirty your cloth. This half, I tell my children, young people, they wear a jeans which is red as eater, half here, half there. So they put a patch here, patch here. I said, why are you putting patch on torn jeans? He said, it is expensive, then what is paper? I said, how? It is torn everywhere. And you kept somewhere the red as eater is a fashion. What fashion of Western fashion? We have our culture, we have become Westernized. So this is a corruption. Starts from your education is corrupt. All the schools, you see the budget in corruption, medical corruption, medicines, this human life. How can you cheat people? Eh? Today I was saying in a mental problem in Uganda, you know, is increasing. Why? Because of frustration.
14 million people are mad, even here could have some mad people.
This is because of frustration, you know, nothing else. My father taught me when I was age of 13. When they are calling me. Age of 13, he said, if your neighbors are poor, you can't eat. Make them happy. So, thank you, Honorable Speaker, to invite me here today. I've learned a lot. And I want you people to promise, write down and 10 points to yourself. Write and promise to yourself. And then you will see the improvement. Don't give the excuses. Today's youth, argument and excuses. Stop that. Be awakening.
Thank you so much
for time. And thank you all, my friends here.